Clo's got it. Moves in down low. Checked as Eves got a stick on it. Clo had to come back. Persistence paid off for Patrick Eves. Clo with a lead pass to Devin Setoguchi. Back for Clo. To the line to Murray. Jimmy Howard got a piece of that. Back for Clo again. Moving right in. Doesn't shoot it. Out front. Malfi got a stick on that. And a chance for Pavelski. Back to Setoguchi. He shoots. That's blocked. Getting in front of it was Miller. Douglas Murray and Malfi collide. Interference coming to Murray. Tom Cowell makes the call. As the hard-hitting Swedish defenseman is going to the box.
Oh, Cronwall skate. Going straight to the dressing room. He can't even step on it. Might be a broken play.
Yep. Looks that way.
Well, battling in front. Right there. Oh, there it goes. The metal is off the blade.
Wow. You don't see that very often.
It's nothing but plastic. And talk about not having an edge. Helpless feeling.
Isn't it?
Oh,
they just out of water there.
San Jose takes the penalty and he gets to go to the dressing room and get the medal inserted.
He ends up coming up with it. Now across the line. Hits a streaking Wilson. Wilson lost his balance. Tries to make a move.
Wilson also lost his skate blade. It's come right off. You can see it in the deep corner right in front of Star Tribune and Enterprise. He pivots, torques that blade hard, and actually snaps right off the bottom of his boot. There you get a good look at it.
Now, I'm no expert, Stu, but I don't think it's very easy to skate like that.
Here we go. Right there, you see just as he pivots, and oh my gosh, he has the presence of mind on one foot. He manages to keep his balance and keep control of that puck, still trying to push it towards the net. Very rare. You'll ever see anything like that, so.
I can't recall ever seeing this. Mark Morawiecki, those pop-out quick change blades, which everybody uses now, unfortunately for Morawiecki, pops out during play.
He's every time he tries to get up, the skate doesn't work. And he's yelling at the official right now, blow the whistle, but the official can't because New Jersey has possession of the puck. I can tell you the whole Ottawa Senator bench out. Look at, was laughing. Nobody could believe it.
Puck comes around to Yanni Gord once again. Works it up and ahead. Point got it back to the line. Trigger check scores! The blade came off of Rask's skate, and he is beside himself.
There's the one that comes through, and you see the blade come right off the skate as Point comes in for the deflection. He knows, he looks over at the referee, he's got his hand up, he's yelling, you know he's yelling. He's waving his hands, this is still no one looking. And then eventually, he can't move and it goes into the net.
Well, the Canadians man advantage on an 0-for-12 run right now, but they get a couple of chances. Thrown in front, Keith will come up with it, and it's fired back out at center. And Shaw, I think, has broken his skate blade here, trying to get to the bench, that's the problem. Now he gets helped off. Here's Kane on the short side and missed. Midway through this second period, and the Blackhawks have a 1-0 lead as the Canadians trying to find their edge in this game.
Cam replay. You don't necessarily want to see these things. That is a full barrel roll. Here we go. And on the backside, when he hit the ice, the blade is no longer at the bottom of the skate. Watch Kopitar. He gets him going, grab onto the end of the stick. Again, nowadays, the blades snap in.
Yakupov, down the ice for Hemsky. Aleš Hemsky moving in against Klein. Here's Hemsky, gets hammered into the boards by Kevin Klein. And Aleš Hemsky takes a look at his skate blade as he is struggling right now. It looks like he
blew it up.
Broke it.
And for Kevin Klein, just kind of leans the butt end of the stick into Hemsky, denies him from driving that puck to the ice. Good job by Yakupov to get that puck out originally. But for Hemsky, tried to get up, and you could tell that something wasn't quite right. He says, I think there's a blade still lying back there. You want to go pick it up for me? And those are those interchangeable blades they have now in the skates. And watch Hemsky try and stand up here. Oops. Does a little bit of a Bambi.
Now it's Diaz on the near board. Stick handles down past the hash marks. It's Gomez firing it on Thomas. He blocks the centering effort. Gomez with a, this will produce a rebound situation, but Thomas got a piece of it, and Andrew Ferentz.
No, he doesn't have a skate blade yet.
Wow, he actually broke the blade off the skate.
Yeah, you can see the blade over where the referee or the linesman and Johnny Boychuk are, and he couldn't do anything.
So Jim Johnson will get to work. Let's set a stopwatch on him, fellas. This is going to be impressive. Keith Robinson and the Bruins equipment staff can rebuild a skate like you read about.
But he's in the mix here, and he makes a nice play, covers the puck up, shovels it across, out of danger. But in that scrum, he's going to lose his blade. And he's trying to kill a penalty, work the front of the net. Difficult to do.
You don't get a stoppage in play for the broken skate. Leski is the referee, helped him a little bit to head towards the bench.
It's pathetic. Really.
Yeah, it is. Bambi with...
Circles the goal. Knocked away by Glendening. He goes back to the line. It was open to play. Off a leg and wide. Broken stick. Lucic thought that was the puck.
He thought the taped stick that broke was
yes,
the puck.
He did. He looked behind him.
Still power play. Look at this wild play. Off a skate. And went off the skate of Lucic right there. Now you think there's two pucks? Look at this. Lucic looks and he goes, where do I go? He goes for this one thinking it's the puck. And he's looking at his left foot. That's a piece of equipment off the back of his skate that he thought was a puck. There's the big guy.
Daniel Alfredson's last shift. Yeah. There's the evidence right there. That's a skate blade. No wonder he was hopping on one foot coming back. It was this big collision behind the net where it happened, and then his skate gets jammed at the heel of his skate. That's why he went down. The heel of his skate hit the wall, and it knocked the blade right out from underneath. So that was him going back to the bench. You're pretty helpless. That's the second time I've seen that in these playoffs.
Get a stoppage of play, and what's been noticed here?
Well, it's David Clarkson. We hope it's just a skate. He did lose the blade. Popped right out of his skate. And as I'm watching, he also took a pretty big blow here as he rolls off this check and hits his back. And sometimes that can just knock the wind out of you. It's Niskanen pulling up. And there you see the right leg of Niskanen coming up high on Clarkson, but David really has no push because there's no blade, nothing but plastic on that left foot.
Here's what happened, as you see, I think he lost an edge on it. Now he couldn't get off. As you see him falling down, he can't get up. And watch the official pushing him to get him off. That's the first. Gordy Dwyer getting it over there. I think he got yelled at from the Pittsburgh bench, but Dwyer's saying that he had a broken skate.
With a Let's Go Rangers chant. As we have four and change left in the opening period, scoreless in game six. Oleksii, his wrister was spoiled. New York comes back through center.
I think Tom Wilson behind the play hasn't got a blade on his skate. Don't think he's hurt, he just can't get that blade up.
That is why he is flailing his way, the 19-year-old rookie trying to get back to the bench. As Wilson is helped to the safety of the Caps bench, Holtby hangs on.
Gotta watch Tom Wilson come in. He's gonna reel McDonough, but his blade is gonna fall off after he makes contact. Check it out, right there, down in the corner. There's the blade that flew off his skate. He had quite the odyssey getting back to the bench. Watch him, he knows right now he's in deep trouble. The linesman and referee won't start the play. An odyssey here in game six.